Good evening, I'm Carol Goldsmith.
And Michael Cogdell. They are four survivors, especially thankful to be alive after a plane crash in Pickens County.
It happened on Sunday, and today the FAA is on the scene trying to figure out what happened.
News 4's Keisha Foster joins us live and local near the crash site on Cedar Ridge Road tonight. Keisha, what'd you find out?
Well, Michael, the latest thing that happened is that work has actually wrapped up for the day, and we just learned that active efforts to remove the plane from that wooded area, which is around that corner, will begin tomorrow morning.
We're here to investigate, recover the aircraft, and we really, that's really all we know. We know that they got out safely, and you know, we're here to basically investigate. We can't speculate because we really don't know what transpired yet.
FAA Inspector Scott Camp arrived Monday morning. The four people on board the Cirrus SR-22 walked away with minor injuries. The plane was traveling from the Atlanta area to Greensboro, North Carolina. The distress call went out around 5 Sunday afternoon. The pilot tried to make it to the Pickens County Airport but couldn't. Emergency Management Director Chuck Haynes says as the pilot glided in, the plane's safety parachute deployed, helping it slow down enough for a safe crash landing. We found company video of how the parachute works on YouTube.
This particular type of aircraft is equipped with a safety parachute mechanism for the plane. The pilot noticed there was some trouble and got to the altitude that he felt that he needed to deploy the parachute. We're always happy to see that somebody walks away from something like this.
And again, work to actively begin removing that plane will start tomorrow morning around 8 and may wrap up tomorrow by late afternoon. And it may be several months before the FAA finds out what caused that plane to crash. Keisha Foster, WYFF News 4, live in Pickens County.